idea what happened in that time.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. And in a minute, the whole game can just change anyway. So we are just waiting for these guys to ready up. Let's go. Oh. Yep, looking forward to this. This is going to be a rebirth match of yesterday, but with different playing people playing different builds, and we've got Zan and Misha in here instead of Karsave, of course.
And a slightly changed setup.
Slightly changed setup, indeed. Interesting to see.
We did have Denshi on an elementalist yesterday.
And no, we didn't.
Oh, on an engineer. Denshinia on an engineer, and Ferlina on a thief. Well, sometimes also on the DPS Guardian, but yep. On a thief then in the matches they won against TCG. So the team that is going to WTS for Europe is going to be facing against off against Abjurt and the Denkening. China and team is remember. I know they are the second place team because the first team, which pretty much stomped everyone else, they had the second place. I think made around 200 points against the first seed, against the first place team. But sadly, the first place can't go. So I'm not too confident in China, but maybe.
They can still improve.
It is still a month away.
Yeah, we've got time for them to improve and to change, and you know, maybe the way they're playing is just completely surprising. But hey ho, we'll have to see how it goes. Oh, thanks.
So a slight rematch of yesterday with a couple of changed.
Same team names, apart
from one player. There's a bit of a mix around here and there. But yeah, it's going to be interesting. George again, we've seen yesterday one of the ways to kind of throw a wrench into the gears of 55 is to perma-train George down.
Yeah,
they had a few really abuse. They really abuse the fact that he's the newest member of the team.
Yeah, that's it.
And went for him in any situation they could.
It got better for him during the games. It did get better for him. So, I mean, it's not really him. It's they've just taken advantage of it, exactly. Like you said. Yeah. So it was a good job. There was a bit of an experience issue there, of course, as well, because. You know, that's just obvious.
Yeah, but I'm going to repeat myself from yesterday. It is also not even... Let's say George would have the same experience to play with 55 in that same manner, but it's the first time for him in a big tournament. Let's say he plays the exact way. If you're new to the team and people just focus you over and over and over again and you're really having a hard time with that, then that's kind of a psychological dig from the enemy team. Take out the new player. Take out the one that might not be as confident as the rest of the team.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's a tactic as well. Seen that in League of Legends. Yeah, I watch LCS. Seen it in League of Legends as well. New guy in the team, and they just completely gank him for the entire match. We'll see. Maybe this time around, it's going to be a bit different. Slight changes on both sides. Therefore, the cards are shuffled new. As we're waiting for these guys to ready up, only one missing. Articuno needs to give the go-ahead, probably at the moment still in a couple of talks concerning the tactic and the splits. It's not as high stakes as yesterday. Yesterday, you could really see that the guys were fighting with the nerfs. It was really stressful, just knowing you're going to lose out on the opportunity to play in Boston at PAX East. And play for $25,000. This time around, it's only the Go 4 points to qualify for the monthly and the €500 prize pool they're fighting for.
Indeed.
So they have readied up, and let's see how they fare against each other. We have 55 HP Monks, the two-time winner of the Go 4 monthly, against Orange Logo, the WTS EU team.
Yeah, I guess we should see Blue Team 55 going up the mid with the two tanky characters again, with the pain train combination going over towards possibly mine now. Good point for George to really see how well George and Chosen Sin work, actually, in this. Actually, as we get over onto the point, they're actually very much together now, getting a lot, not really a lot of damage on Articuno, but he's having to use a lot of his cooldowns there. We're going to see Frey coming back over to this point now as well. They're going to pull out. George is going to bail and actually go to mid. That's a good idea. Versus Rom, they might be able to get the 2-cap here if we can get up there quick enough. The Chosen Sin getting down into
the
cleave.
They are on them. They immediately leave Chosen Sin by taking out before they even can engage on the mid fight, and everyone just left from there. Fridlina just having an eye that he doesn't just self-res himself. A bit of damage on that one, and now we have a double cross over beach. Actually, no, Fridlina just having an eye out, tries to go for the immobilize, misses with that nice ring of warding to keep him down, and tries to take him out before it even gets to the point. He can definitely contest the point, and maybe just this is ample time for reinforcements to come if necessary. The respawning Chosen will now definitely spot Articuno, but maybe it's just to pull players away from there. I don't know if only... Oh, Chosen is actually on a Sword Dagger build.
Oh, okay. I didn't spot that change.
He
actually
was Panic Strike when I looked, so he switched very recently. Sword Dagger, that is a lot better in a 1v1 against an Ellie.
Yeah, I think that's what he's going for, isn't it? Maybe he's thinking about not roaming George.
At least he can contest for a longer time.
Yeah, that's true. He can evade a lot of that AoE damage on the point. The Chosen Sin is going to get stuck here, though. Feels like he's dying a bit more in this build, though. He's been taken out twice now, almost. He's not out down yet, of course. He can be res. Zan has been taken
trying
out.
Trying to go for the res. We have the Ring of Warding again. Will Misha be able? No, Misha is just going to let him die. That is good. No overcommitment to the Rezzer. So that is one of the weak points of 55 they had in the past. But they have worked on that. They have worked on that.
Yeah,
and
they've
definitely improved.
They did do it one time yesterday, though, where it really changed the game, where they all went for the res, panic res, and the kind of all were taken out. Now they're having a couple of problems where Chosen Sin's only just coming back into the game. So is Zan. And they can potentially come over and just back up Misha now, just allowing Misha to move. There we go. So she can actually go over towards the mid and actually help out with this fight, which is happening over here. EC is currently 1v1. Should be okay for a bit, especially if he gets any support. But actually, we're going to see Misha going back towards the Henge because we've got a little bit more action happening over here. We have seen Denshi coming in with, Hannah Montana coming in as the thief there, as Articuno does escape, but gets pulled back by Zan there. Nice job getting that nice conditions down with the grenades. Of course, Articuno can take away those conditions, and he's just going to bail over towards mid using that fire greatsword.
And
as
George
well.
Is down. Tage doing his job of taking out the pain train together with Rom. Easy work of George, and Johnson just barely gets out of that one alive. Refocusing their endeavors on the midpoint. It's going to be a 2-cap, currently very close. Oh no, George! Chosen! What is he doing? He's actually going for the 1v1, tries to take out Rom. I don't think he really could take that 1v1, or it's going to be really close. It's easier in that build, definitely against a Shout Warrior, but still really, really tough. Tage actually is apparently confident in Rom's abilities and completely leaves him alone. We have George now coming there as well. Chosen Sin disengaging for the time being. Does he want to help with George? Two people now trying to take out Rom, as we have quite the big team fight in the bottleneck between Keep and Hench.
Yeah, I mean, at the moment, 55 are losing players very, very quickly. They're losing most of these like skirmishes and these fights, and there's going to be a couple of reasons because of that. Obviously, EC's now back on staff, staff elementalist, and we're seeing Misha playing as a bunker guardian, which is random as well. And not that EC doesn't play staff, he plays staff early for quite a long time, but he might be okay here, actually getting the rest from Misha potentially, but there's too much cleave there.
George going down, called by Fridlina. Two DPS guardians are just a tough thing to deal with.
Chosen Sin, nice. I saw, maybe he'll get the res here.
Burning is still on him, and he will. Back up goes George, and we have Zenanen as a support. Rom goes down, Fridlina trying to go for the res. No, he can't, too much damage. Fridlina needs to disengage. Yeah. Leaves the mine point open, and did we see a knockback? Rom actually off point, so they can leave him to bleed and want to catch Fridlina. Chosen just barely withdraws away from him. Could be down in a couple of seconds if the next engage comes, but George is also there to try and take him out. And maybe now we're going to see an open on the midpoint. I think that's the logical solution.
Or they could just go for a cheeky boss kill, maybe. They could have just burst that down, but they can actually take advantage, like mid, you said, going to mid.
Mid is worth a bit more.
Yeah, yeah. Articuno is there, getting that Chaos Storm, but on the point is going to cause him problems as well. And we're going to see loads of damage coming onto Articuno now. He's doing a good job at just trying to face tank it as well.
And get the decap. Come on, get the decap. You need to be fast enough. We just did the reinforcement. No, George, why? He could have gotten it. I think he just walked past or walked over the point. Didn't quite get it. It would have been close. He might not have gotten it. And if he stayed on there, it could have been his death, which would be detrimental if he didn't get the decap and he's dead. But the decap could also have been worth a lot. They stealthed up. They're going for the hench point now. Tage on there. He, of course, can do a lot of damage and negate the first bit of burst. But after 30 seconds, he is pretty sure to go down.
I mean, losing that cap over on the mine now, they tried to be offensive. They needed to be a lot quicker over on the midpoint there. Zan actually getting that nice pull onto Rom. Hopefully they can get just a few caps here as Isi's on the point. And also Zan is just going to try and 1v1 now. I think Isi's going to leave him in that situation. He was better off, but Rom is going to be okay. He's got only got a couple of conditions. Nice knockback, actually, from Zan, able to immobilize him off point as well, using that rifle 2 ability.
On Dench, currently the defender of the midpoint. Will we see a decap coming out? Yes, there we go. Misha still on point. Chosen in a bit of trouble. He needs to be careful for the next engage. Can he dodge away? Is he mobilized? Going down. Issei and Misha both ready to get the res. Oh, we saw a bit of a weird knockdown. Ring of Warding coming out, but the stability is up for him to just dodge his way out of there.
Yeah, it's still like 70 or 80 points ahead at the moment. Mid fight's really going to be quite a big issue. If they can't, 55 needs to lock this down as soon as possible. They need to try and take off maybe Articuno, but then they probably need to take out Tage, who's coming into the point, actually. It's just dropping below mid now.
Is very nice. A stealth up, man. Kind of got scared about the possible decap on the hench, falling back, leaving Articuno alone. Then she kind of smelt it.
Yeah, he got knocked back there with the...
That could be really what brings 55 ahead now. Yeah, double cap coming out.
For sure. Two kills as well. They're still in the down state. They need
now,
to push.
Will they play this defensively or try and take advantage of the fact that two players are down?
Well, they've got respawns. They need to deal with those respawns that are going to come out.
They need to get another kill now. They need to get another kill now, otherwise they're not going to have any advantage of that.
Why are they moving mid? There's three players from Orange Logo over a mid.
Oh,
so
yeah, no, it's
left.
Actually a good idea. Respawn on the enemy close.
Yeah, I said that, but the thing is, like, two players versus Tage and others, like, we've already seen Nisi go down there. Misha isn't going to last long.
They're
going to
be fast enough for at least a decap on the hench.
Maybe.
At least a decap, with Fiery Greatsword, if he gets fast enough. No, won't, but can still contest the point. Both of them might be able to. Nice knockdown. Burst comes out. Last dodge. A dodge there in last second. Arm of Earth is on there. And now Tage to make it very difficult for George and Chosen.
It's actually not ended up as too bad a move. But the thing is, they've just lost two supporting characters there. Misha and EC there. Misha playing the Guardian, of course. And now they're in a 1v1. Zan's in a 2v1 situation where he's just gone down. They're actually going to lose the 2-cap now. They are respawning, so they should be able to get Henge okay, but I really think they just sent too many people back over for that respawn. Maybe you only needed to just keep it as a 2v2. Send one person, maybe Chosen with Zan, but not three people back. Not too sure about that move there from those guys. That could have been the nail in the coffin. We'll have to wait and see.
Maybe they were expecting a better engage. Chosen down on the side. Denshi managed to catch him off guard. Zen tried to go for the rest, I think, or at least a bit of support. Now needs to bail off that. Is being chased by Hannah as well as Frey. Tage even making his way up there, so the mid decap is not going to be it, but still a contestion on the hench. That, however, is not really worth anything if you're looking at a double cap for the enemy team.
Yeah, exactly. They need to pull back. This is a problem that we're having for, I think, teams against Orange Logo. As soon as they get like a big lead, it just seems like you can't almost pull it back, especially at the moment. And they've, you know, 55 HP monks have got a little bit of few issues here with the EC obviously not playing, people not playing their usual builds, just say that. But saying that, Hannah Montana Denshi is playing Thief at the moment, seems to be doing absolutely fine. as he is, and they're doing. I think Orange logo has just been very pressurized. They're pressurizing most points at the moment. Even Tage is just kind of hovering around mid. It's not too bad over on the windmill though. On the mine at the moment though. Sorry, George is going to.
Oh yeah, they're actually getting the cab. They're actually getting the cab, but they need somebody defensive on there. Misha needs to pull back, otherwise that cab has gone fast. And he wasn't a chase. Yeah.
Wow. It's like Misha's kind of running around as if she's almost a mesmer.
I think.
But that's the problem. But they're getting some nice focus now on Rom. This is better targeting, but I think it's a bit too late in the day. It's like 450 points at the moment. Maybe if they can get a decap mid, someone needs to move now.
Oh no, the rest is not quite enough, but we have a nice ring of warding catching George in there. He tried to port out but couldn't quite manage to do it. Somebody really needs to go mid or this is over already. But Tage and Frelina, they need to kill one of them before they get there. Otherwise, the reinforcements from the hench point are going to come. They're going to abandon the hench, so double outer point cap, maybe one staying. Somebody needs to have an eye on the mine. Respawn.
Oh my good lord. Really?
That's going to be the decap.
Really?
And that is the nail in the coffin of 55. First game will, in a couple of seconds, go over to Orange Logo.
That was a big mistake, yeah. I mean, I know they had to be very offensive in going, and they had a portal over there as well, but not coming back through early enough.
Misha actually reacted pretty fast to that, saw that happening, but the portal pull was not fast enough.
No. Just, you know, some big problems there for 55 HP Monks, but it was close for a while. Taking the first game, will Orange Logo take the Gofor Cup as well as the WTS qualifiers in the same weekend, which is just going to push them up to even more money?
Yeah.
Like, soon they will be able to, like...
They've already got 2.5k secured.
They don't need a part-time job. They can just play Guild Wars 2.
as a part-time job, yeah. Maybe not a full-time job, but a part-time job for that. If you're good enough, you can make a decent amount of money with this.
It's true. You don't need to go work at the supermarket. You don't need
WTS
to be pushing trolleys around.
Three times a year? Or at least two times now. The last one was last year.
Well, we'll have... I guess we'll have three this year. We'll have three a year.
Maybe. I'm not sure. We know of two.
Will we, Nick? Do you
know of two? So potential $50,000 a year from that one alone, and then we have quite a few Gofor Cups.
Yep, 52.
That's 52, 400. If you just that's potentially, if you win all of that,
that's 20
and
grand.
Then all of the monthlies.
Yeah. That's a lot of money, actually.
That's
a lot of money. I'm going to calculate this. I want to do this right now.
Do the math, Jeb. Do the math.
And remember, the monthlies and the weeklies. Oh, my God. I'm doing this right now. Live calculation. Okay, let's think about this. So 52
times 400.
400. Okay.
Times,
that's 21.
Plus 12 times. So 12,000. For all the monthlies, if we have one every month, and then you have at least 50, potentially 75 grand from WTS. If you win all of
it. Euros. Change it into euros.
Oh, damn.
75 grand into euros.
That's about 20.
No?
Yeah,
the
euro isn't that great anymore.
Oh,
the
okay.
exchange rate is pretty poor right now.
It's not going to be 20,000.
Oh.
That's rubbish. That's really bad.
Okay.
Well, this is an exponential amount of money. That is ridiculous.
Yes, it is.
Okay, it's €1 is almost $1. Wow. That sucks.
Yeah.
My God, there really is almost no difference in the price.
I've still got a couple of dollars lying around. I'm going to save them for when the euro really tanks.
Yeah, okay. Oh, wow, I didn't know that. Proud to be English right now. So let's plus another 50 on... No, let's say 48. Oh, my God.
So, while we're waiting for the ready-ups of the teams... Currently, Orange Logo in the lead with one win in these best of three. They could secure the win directly after being the WTS EU team. Are they going to pick up the Gofor again? So, how much is it? Jabba.
Oh,
how much money?
I actually stopped doing it.
Come on. it's right, somewhere, depending on whether they're three or two WTS in a year, there's a potential of somewhere around...
Oh my god!
What?
That's insane!
Yes?
Okay, that's like...
Oh, tax.
60, that's like 80 grand-ish a year.
Potential money if you potential. Win all of it. Which is unlikely, but...
Yeah, which is unlikely, but for Orange Logo, it's not. They could get a good chunk of that in a year. That's insane money! What the hell? You could actually be quite comfy off, like, I mean, 20 grand a year each. No, like 15, 17, something like that.
It's definitely a good part-time job. or side job.
Or just do Guild Wars 2 and then like get a part-time job. That's epic. That is so epic. Well, that is, I've never really worked it out before, but yeah.
Yeah, compared to the money we get for casting, which is none. that is pretty good. You are correct.
But we get taken out to PAX.
Okay.
Stuff, which was very awesome.
We are very grateful for that.
Yeah, it's very, very grateful good. For that. Very cool. Right, so, Fofire.
Yeah. As soon as these guys ready up, how are we looking? Oh, there we go. As soon as I want to look as if I commanded them.
55 should put that George guy on Shoutbow and have Misha on Play Mesmer. That's actually probably not a bad decision, but I think he'd probably be more comfortable on Mesmer because that's what he plays.
Exactly. So, for the potential last match, because I haven't said that yesterday enough times, Orange Logo on the red side versus 55 HP Monks on the blue.
Oh, God, there we go. And having a look at the splits at the moment, going to have a look at... Oh, what are Frey's going to go over to far? Have we seen a stealth
up? Oh, no, the Moa missed. The Moa missed. Oh. That is, of course, not a good start. They're trying to get Rom down either way. That's a good target because he, of course, has the battle standard. Was interrupted quite a few times. Tries to jump up the gravestones. Does manage to, and the damage should take care of him. There isn't really any possibility for a res. And the quarry is actually completely ignored. And that is what Chosen will pick up now.
Good job. Oh, Misha. Ah, dropped so low there. So low. Have we seen...
Oh, wait. Misha is on an Ellie now. And okay. Issei.
It
so
makes more
those
sense.
Two switch.
Yeah. It makes more sense to keep, you know, keep the people who have been playing those builds on those builds rather than actually switching everyone around. But, yeah, so that does make a lot more
sense. What kind of an Ellie is he? Staff Melandru Cleric. So, yeah, same build.
Yeah, same build. So maybe that's what they do.
Comp.
They're trying to learn each other's builds and stuff. But, you know, these guys multi-class and whatnot as well anyway.
Six shoes coming out. Not really that much coming off it now. Slightly currently 455. We do see Rom. What is Rom doing at the quarry? Because against George... Oh, he's only... no, Chosen Sin is in there as well. I thought Chosen Sin was an illusion for a second. But no, he is real as he gets. And we see again the defense mechanic of the spawn going back through the red gate, being safe from the pain train. In mid, Misha is holding out against three people at the moment. He might need some reinforcements. Why are Zen and Issei just on the side there, now only jumping
running
in?
About a bit.
Bit of support there. But Misha's still alive.
Should be okay. Articuno is just trying to bail out a little bit, but he's actually going to go over for...
They actually,
it's just
they actually
like
opened the door, and Rom is still there.
Oh my god.
Rom just... They just kept him in there. They kept him.
That's actually, it's not a bad idea, but they need to get back to their quarry and
Chosen
actually defend
needs help.
It.
Chosen yeah, really needs help against Fridolin, although it got close, got knocked back from the dodge into the Ring of Warding while he was teleporting. Now being chased by Fridolin, he really wants Chosen dead. He's trying to help against Tage. That's another DPS Guardian. That is difficult for him. Oh, he just goes through. Nice. Taking advantage of the fact that somebody needs to keep mid and can't really fall back to 1-4. Chosen is going to get the decap. Oh, just slightly out of range due to the ports. The Immobilized doesn't connect and the decap is coming out on the waterfall.
Oh, it's all good. Oh, it's going quite well on the waterfall now. Chosen Sin again is on the position where he's just on the node. Why are they doing this to him? It feels like pain. Chosen
Sin got the decap. He maybe should have disengaged afterwards, but the move itself was good.
It would, the initial move, yes. But if they're not going to follow it up with someone coming out to help him, especially when George is respawning now, you know, maybe just hover around, just jump on the point, try and keep it decapped and contested rather than engaging in the fight. But maybe he thought he could take it. Unfortunately, he didn't. He is now in a bit of trouble coming up from behind. He's got his heal off cooldown, but oh, no interrupts there to try and use that. He's going to be a completely fine.
Oh, are they going
to
give up the mid cap? No, Issei is around as well as Zan. Both are going to go on the point at the same time. We have a supply crate drop coming in to give Issei some. Wait, did we? No, I think it got interrupted. There, second try. There we go, supply crate comes out, and that is supposed to help him enough. He actually activated the slick shoes and put most of it off point. Because maybe he got the command to help Misha out against Rom a bit too late. Articuno also coming in. Is he being chased by George? No, only a couple of illusions. Hannah Montana with the engage on George. He is able to save himself, and Chosen Sin actually had the refuge ready for him to be saved.
Indeed. I mean, that was just a full rotation out there. That's why I was there. And then they dropped the Fire Great Sword so that Misha could go over towards the mid and actually support over there. Misha now on point with Chosen Sin as well. They're trying to just pin down that looks like Articuno off point. What up, Fraze? Probably needs to be their next main target if they can probably pick him up. Tage is there as well, though. Tage drops down. Hannah Montana really stuck now. Has been able Frilina to stealth.
On George. Is they coming in for the rest? I don't think it's going to happen. No. Just punt the George. Punt the George out of the way. Tage and Fridolin just with the knockbacks there out of range.
Got this 1v1 happening
over on. Good decision to abort that. Yeah, still one point between these teams at the moment.
Yes,
one
it's
point.
Really close. Seems that this mix-up was a good idea for 55 HP monks
Almost able to get chosen. It's just barely alive. Did he manage to get into into stealth? Yes, he did. Issei as well. Issei with his support there. No chance for them to get there. But Zananan is down. Issei needs to get there quick. Otherwise, this is over. Oh, can we get an interrupt on that? No, the steal wasn't quite ready. Otherwise, he might have been able to save him. Oh, that immobilized off point. Will it be the decap? Issei not on point.
No.
Decaps comes out. Punt the chosen.
Yeah,
off
they
point.
Needed to just have someone on node there, but maybe Issei is just not prepared to give up his life and the potentiality that there's going to be other people dead on the map. They don't want to lose more than one player at this point, because otherwise they can just run over the map even more. So if they lose that mid cap and orange logo get the free cap, it'll be really just a snowball effect. They'll just run away with the game and it'll be too strong.
Just to remind ourselves, second ago, only one point between them. Now this could have an entirely different end.
And this map is like, it's like that, you know. You've always got mid is like so contested because of the size of it. And then the side cap's easy to take. Like,
and because it's so close to the side caps.
Exactly. So you can always go for those decaps. And then if you suddenly get a two cap, it just really runs away. We've already got 50 so points in the last minute or so. And it's just, it starts to really, really, really pull away. So you've really got to pressurize. And at the moment, they could probably send someone to Quarry as well, just to put some concession there so they can pull someone out from one of these fights, orange logo-wise, and actually, you know, hopefully get over there and get that decap. I mean, they've got the decap on waterfall there as well.
Denshi's going for the gate, but George is there. Oh, George actually, no, he doesn't want that fight. Just the auto attacks and a bit of a sigil proc there.
Yeah, it took him down quite low. He's just waiting for his health to regenerate, I think. Always going to nip out now as he's aware that maybe Hannah Montana is bailing, but he's actually going to put some focus back onto George there. Zan is going to come back out to actually... Oh, a nice dupe there. As George comes out, Zan came towards him to make sure that Hannah Montana wasn't going to focus him, knowing that, you know, there was a lot of damage coming out from Denshi onto George there. So a good way to negate that is Han dropping loads of grenades around his body. Again, dropping those grenades on the SR as Hannah tries to regenerate. And then Hannah just jumps back onto George immediately. This is what you've got to do. If you're a thief playing Guild Wars 2, and there's a Mesmer
and
on the team.
Back in the base we go.
Yeah, exactly. He's doing the right thing. That's exactly what he's supposed to do. And if people are new to Guild Wars 2 and you're playing Thief and you're not focusing those big DPS, like bursty characters, that's one of the things, that's one of your jobs. You've got to do that. Yeah. And he's doing a good job doing it.
But you also need to be careful that they don't just turn around and say, wait, you're punching me. No, I'm going to punch you.
Exactly, exactly. But in this case, George is not really being offensive in that, so he's just been kept Chosen. In the base.
Chosen is really trying to go for the decaps right now, but he has always negated one of the DPS guardians on him. And you can't run away from a DPS guardian. They have the port if they need it. They have all the immobilizers and Ring of Warding as well. Trying to do it as well. Is he going to go for it? Yes, he is, just with the ports. Maybe fast enough, but Felina got that port, got that immobilized. And George, again, that is the focus target.
We have had a DC on the side of Orange Logo at the moment. Whether or not someone is going to AFK on 55 HP monks, normally they do.
It is too George's late AFK. In the game to do a reset. AFK.
And they are winning. So.
Yeah, and they are winning.
Okay, George is going to go AFK. He's in the downstairs as well, so he's probably the best person to do that. Although he's getting rezzed. They're trying to rezz someone who's going to be AFK anyway, so I'd probably
that
just let him die.
Maybe not smart. Well, okay, the storm is going to come out. At least they tried. At least they tried. It's not just a thing of, well... Oh yeah, they might have the similar problem again of if they put the Mesmer AFK. We saw that, which match was it? We had one match where they actually put Misha AFK and that was the damage they were lacking. I think against Cheese Mode. And the Mesmer AFK completely screwed them over.
Just look at the Chosen Sin now. Isn't it getting, doing some nice jobs? Nice job against Hannah Montana, but... At the moment, actually doing a good job himself as he comes out of stealth. Now, Han's going to jump onto Chosen Sin there. Really equal HP. Just, oh god, got caught there by a little bit of cleave. Hannah, watch out. And now Chosen Sin's coming up from behind, dropping the SR. Is Chosen Sin going to go for it? No, he's not going to drop any AoE onto that SR so there, actually.
We can see Misha is AFK just jumping around randomly on the walls. We are waiting for the player to reconnect, and as soon as that happens, we will probably have Misha jumping back into the game. But until that time comes, it is a 4v4, and this 4v4 is currently for Orange Logo in the range to go for Lord. They don't really have the situation for it at the moment, though. Frelina down. Oh, then she went for the Hannah Montana went for the res, and he got caught with a lot of cleave damage. Chosen Sin there to finish the job off, and now Articuno is just trying to somehow keep the midpoint.
Yeah, he should be okay for a bit of time, although he's going to be in a 3v1 situation. Is it 3v1 situation? Yeah, maybe. Going over towards the waterfall as well. Zan's able to keep that contested into that decal. I think he's... Might be... Yeah, there you go. Might be able to win this against Rom now. Get some nice Condi burst.
Was really close.
Yeah, I mean... Oh, did a nice job of line of sight, and Zan's just trying to regenerate inside that healing of his supply crate there and picking up those medical
kits. Oh, and the knockbacks immobilized. That is going to be the cap. He has a pull ready. No!
Oh!
Not quite.
He's got his cooldowns off nearly as well. He's got that Fear Me, so he needs to be careful now. Put himself into a position where he's against that fence. He gets that Fear Me off. He's going to be able to regenerate well.
Oh, and there we go.
Okay, Hannah.
Helpful Hannah coming in, but the mid cap might still be it. Yeah. They are not in a position. Oh, we have them back. So we do see Misha jumping back into action as well as... Was it Articuno who disconnected? Apparently. Because he's the lowest down. Yeah, just coming out of the spawn now. So a 5v5 again. But it has still pretty much turned the tides here. 455.
Yeah, exactly. We can see the guys, maybe even Rom, actually going for that gate. Because now they can go for the Lord, of course. 55 HP monks have the two things to worry about. They have to keep the caps, come back into the game. Whereas Orange Logo, they can just go for the Lord and worry about that. I mean, they've got the Thief, they've got the two DPS guardians.
Zan is trying to... Oh, yeah, he's going for the decap on the Waterfall. Brom doesn't want to let that happen. Leaves the door for...
Chosen's coming over as well. It's George as well. Three-man push towards Waterfall. They're going to get the decap.
Yeah, that's going to be the decap. Now they need
to... come back, hype.
maybe split off and go for the Lord themselves.
Oh wow, some immense damage there. Rom coming back. A nice position to put that support with the banner down to get the res. Good job from them. Slow comeback.
But the battle standard is out, and
Nick,
we do have
left.
The decap. 2 minutes. That could really now be the one for the Lord. If we get them into a, let's say, 300 plus range, then a Lord is a possibility if 55, if Orange Logo haven't got any more points then. They will get the caps, but they should still have enough room to work with. For a quick mesma, possibly. Oh no, Misha,
they're gonna get
knocked off the. Yeah, and that is now really, really difficult. A minute 50. We have Rom down, Tage and Articuno still on the point. Three people trying to take them down. This 3v3 is definitely going in favor of 55, but is it going to be fast enough? Tage already bailing off point. Articuno left. They need the cap to get into 350 range, but with the time
really being as it is,
and they are only 100, they have about 40 points of room to go for the Lord, potentially.
They need a decap over here on the quarry, fast.
They don't necessarily, and they're going for the Lord. Zenanan is on his way. No, he's not on his way for the gates.
No, he
wants to take the really long way around. Oh, we actually have an open gate. He's going for that.
Mm-hmm.
We have an open gate. Hannah Montana
saw that. Maybe chosen. Oh, they're going for the decap. Articuno going for the decap over in Waterfall. Maybe.
Oh, no, he won't. Oh, he will. Oh, he will. It's going to be really close. 50 seconds left. We are almost at 350 with that double cap. Only five points left.
Mid is
going
to
be decapped. That is not going to be enough. No, Frelina is going to get the decap. One point before. It's going to be one point away from the win. But I think if it's not a triple cap, the time is not going to be enough. That should still be the win if they get the Red Lord down.
Can you imagine if
that
we'd gone...
That should still be the win, but they need to be faster. That engage is completely failed. 55 is down.
Oh.
I'm just seeing, and that Lord Rush did not really help them. 1 point away from winning this with the Lord Rush, but a lot of damage away from actually getting the Lord. That is Orange Logo's game. 7 seconds. That is barely enough for George to respawn. And that is going to be the 2-0 victory.
Insane. Good.